In this chapter, we will be discussing how to turn on your pump, how to attach the cassette of your TPN bag, and also how to prime your tubing of your TPN. The supplies that you will need for this is your warmed up pre-mixed TPN, your CADD Solis pump, and your package of AA batteries. The first thing we want to do is add the batteries to the CADD pump. These should be changed daily. To do this, you can use your fingers, a coin, or the CADD key to turn the knob on the battery compartment, which is at the top of your pump, counterclockwise. It will then open. You want to use 4 new batteries. Do not mix old and new batteries. This can cause a pump alarm for power. So using the markings on the pump and the markings on the battery, put the batteries in the battery compartment. Push the battery door closed and turn the knob clockwise. So now that you've replaced the batteries, you want to push the on and off button located at the side of your pump. This pump will go through a self-test mode and you will hear 6 audible beeps. Once you hear those beeps, that means that the pump has successfully turned on. If the pump has not successfully turned on, you would hear an alarm at this time. You also want to make sure that you do not attach the cassette prior to the self-test startup. Now that the pump has successfully turned on, you want to open the latch located on the side of your pump. Now we can attach the cassette. Put the pegs into the hinge pins. And push down on a firm surface. Pull up on the latch, and you will see high volume administration set latched appear on the top of the screen briefly. If you meet resistance, or if you notice a gap in between the pump and the cassette, start over. Now a message will display of prime tubing. You want to press the soft key, yes. It will then bring up a message that says disconnect tubing from the patient, open the clamps, and press prime. You are then going to push the soft key right under prime. This pump will automatically prime your tubing with 20 mils of fluid. This should be enough to get to the tip of the end of your tubing. You also want to ensure during this process that the filter attached to your tubing is in an up and down motion. So after your pump has finished priming with the 20 mils, occasionally there is some air left in the tubing. If you notice any air, you want to continue priming, you would press yes. This will automatically prime with another 20 mils. So after you've noticed that the air is removed from the tubing, you're going to press stop priming. It will then give you that message again to say continue priming. At the point where there is no longer air in the tubing, you are going to press the soft key under no. It will then display, do you want to start the pump? Once again, you are going to push no. This is because we want you to always double check your settings on your pump with the label of your TPN bag. To do this, go to your task, the soft key under your task. Scroll down until you highlight View Delivery Settings. Push Select in the middle of your keypad. You now want to verify that all of the settings on your pump match your TPN bag. Scroll through the settings, verifying that these are correct. You also want to note your reservoir volume. If your reservoir volume does not match your bag, we will discuss how to manually reset your reservoir volume in Chapter 8. If everything looks correct on your pump and your label, press the back button until you reach the home screen. Remember, this is very important to do prior to starting your pump to ensure that you are getting the correct amount of medication. It is also good to note, when you are in the task, when you're in the view delivery settings, you will notice a taper up and taper down. If these are at zero, that means that your medication will be administered at a steady, continuous rate. If your pump is programmed to a taper up or taper down, your pump will run slower at first and then ramp up as it goes. Again, it will do this at the end of your infusion. You'll now notice that your pump is running slower towards the end of your infusion than in the middle of your infusion.